What if the Colorado Rockies were never purchased and moved to New Jersey in 1982? Would there be a Mr. Devil? A Marty's Better chant? Championship banners? Would New Jersey have a professional sports team of its own?
So it was great. I loved it. It was, like I said, I'll never forget 1982, the Devils came here. I still call it the old Brendan Byrne Arena, you know, but it was huge. And youth hockey took off after that. And then, you know, with the three cups, you know, the rest is history. I mean, hockey's booming in New Jersey right now.
And it just became such a popular sport. And a big thing is because of the New Jersey Devils. And it's New Jersey, you're a great athlete. You play basketball, baseball, or football. Now you see a lot of great athletes playing hockey. And I think it's because Dr. McMullen and his family brought the New Jersey Devils to the state of New Jersey.
You can't count how many arenas have grown. I mean, I don't know the exact number, but I always use the analogy. I think when I came in 1982, there was like six indoor ice rinks in the whole state, and what is there, 60 to 70 now in the state of New Jersey, and I think large part, certainly the Devils putting hockey on the map, Dr. McMullen bringing the team here to New Jersey.
Since 1982, a team named the Devils has resided in the Garden State.
Dad liked a challenge. There was a challenge of getting an NHL team into New Jersey. I think he felt a great deal of pride in bringing the team to New Jersey, where he was a native son.
Well, I think the biggest thing is he was so passionate about the game and the team. You know, moving the team here was a big step. I mean, a big step, and certainly great for New Jersey hockey.
He loved his Devils, and you know, he disliked the opponent just as much as we did as a team, our rivals. That's what makes sports, the fans going at it. But no, those were our trials, and they continue to build over the years, and we wanted to be the best team in the tri-state area, and we did that three times.
He's a hard-working guy. He expected his team to work hard and perform, and I think we did that pretty well for him over the years. But you know, he would always have us over to the house as a group. He's a family guy, which is really important, I think. Remember the family part, and you know, he loved his dogs, loved the outdoors. He had two black labs, which I remember he'd always have them with him.
I think my favorite memory of Dr. McMullen is no matter where he went and where he was, he always had his best friend with him, Bubba. Bubba and Dr. McMullen went hand in hand no matter where they were.
Hall of Fame players and legendary coaches.
It really spurred hockey in New Jersey, especially at the youth level. More Devils fans started from that young age, and if you look at a lot of players being drafted from New Jersey, so the New Jersey's really taken off as a hotbed for hockey, and that's all because of Dr. McMullen.
Record set that may never be broken.
Yeah, that presence that every time you walked in a room, like you knew, you know, Dr. McMullen was around, you know.
1983 was the year I was drafted, and you know, the first thing you're going to meet a guy that owns a NHL hockey team, you're expecting titan of industry, which he was, but you know, I think the biggest thing that stuck out was he was just a regular person.
Three Stanley Cups hoisted for the Devils and the state of New Jersey.
Championships, and especially the first one for Dr. McMullen. Dr. Mac had the vision, him holding it in 1995. His eyes welling up out what it meant to him being able to reap the rewards and benefits of holding that Stanley Cup. Great to be able to bring a Stanley Cup, our first one in New Jersey with Dr. Mack.
A beautiful building now stands in Newark, New Jersey. Is decorated with numerous banners celebrating championships and legendary careers. A plaza for all to revel in the many accomplishments and a statue forever enshrined. Many people have contributed to the history, growth, and excellence of the Devils organization. But only one man's vision started it all. A vision that changed the National Hockey League and New Jersey sports forever.